Hi, I'm Patricia Bleckman with KE2 Therm. This video is a look at the quickest way to narrow down the choices and select the appropriate controller for your install. It's a simple matter of comparing the general feature set of each controller. So we made a visual summary in our controller comparison sheet. This sheet lists the main features of each controller that we know are important to you. Now, across the top is the list of our controllers. Then down the side are the differentiating features. Beginning with defrost requirements, obviously an air defrost controller like the KE2 Temp is designed to be used on medium temperature applications. Now, if you need fan and defrost heater control, you want to make sure those features are available. Other defrost features that can help you determine the right controller are how the defrost is initiated on a time-based schedule or using KE2 Therm's adaptive or demand defrost feature. So if maximizing energy savings is important to you, you can skip to the fourth column on the table. Continue down the list and you'll see the availability of an alarm notification. Alarm alerts used to be a huge differentiator. Now, when using the KE2 LDA, all of the controllers have the capability to send alarm notification via text or email. However, if you need detailed data logging for diagnostic, you will need to select the KE2 Evap or KE2 Evap RE or KE2 Controlled Environment. Further down the column, you see the features like valve control. This varies from mechanical TEV for all of our controllers to the controllers with the ability to control multiple electric valves. For example, the KE2 Evap rack efficiency can control an EEV and an electronic pressure regulating valve or electronic hot gas bypass valve. Using the table to eliminate controllers based on these features will help you pinpoint the best controller fit for your application. If you have more questions to help with your selection, you can visit our website or you can contact our technical support line.